Ladies and gentlemen, there lies a fine line between living a large life and a long life. Today, I stand here before you all to convince you all, to motivate you all, to plead you all, to try to live a large life and not a long life. What is the difference, the essential difference between a large life and a long life? A person who lives a long life will wake up every day in the morning. Another 24 hours again, I'm going back to sleep. And he shifts those days, the hours from that day, onto the next day. A person who lives a large life will wake up in the morning and say, I have only 24 hours to go. I must be meticulous. I must work hard. Toastmasters and guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Coming to last night, how many of you here have actually lived a large life today? Anyone at all? Anyone? Yeah. Okay. How many of you have lived a single day in your life? Been away for 24 hours and will remember that day till day? Anyone? Shriram, wrote 26th of Republic Day, 26th of January 2016. Republic Day. You're an Indian. No, yet I'm talking about the OVT, the Outbound Training Program, where we woke up at 3 a.m. in the morning on the 26th and we flew on at 1 a.m. in the morning the next day on the 27th. I remember that morning when the guys were really depressed and were almost crying when they heard that the girls had all had to be on one bus together. And when Navneet and Richard and Melvin got up with all the girls and they left us, the guys. But no girls, we had a lot of fun. We got the stereo fixed in half an hour and we started dancing. I remember Courtney and others dancing like crazy people. We wanted to dance like crazy people. And the waterfall, of course, I must keep my voice low, but the waterfall was amazing. That entire day, I remember everything which happened that day. But why do I remember that day? Because that day was the best day this semester till date. Because I was up for 22 hours and it felt like a minute. And I'd go and live that day over again, over and over again, until I got tired. Moving on to that day, when I was just 8 years old, we went to my parents' place for lunch. Sorry, my grandparents' place for lunch. And my aunt had come home. And she had prepared lunch for us. Now, I was really notorious kid back then. If there was a marriage and there was a cup of water, I would throw my slippers into it. I would throw the telephone off the terrace. So I was really notorious kid. And essentially what I decided to do was pluck off all the flowers from the petals. I mean pluck off all the petals from the flowers, which were kept on the dining table. And I decorated the initials of her name to them. She was really happy to see that. But I was really unhappy to hear the sad news. 2 days later, she had passed away. And she never got to know the fact that I had done that amongst the 4 children who were there. That taught me something out here. That life is full of surprises and you don't know what's going to come up next. Live every moment to your fullest because you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Moving on to timeline. In the year 2011, a movie called Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara came out. How many of you have watched that movie? Yeah. For those who don't know what that means, Richard, do you know what it means?
Yeah, you don't know what it
means. I truly don't know. Okay, it means you don't live life a second time. And that's a very... And that movie actually touched my life. That not just because that was the first movie my parents allowed me to go out with my friends for the first time, but because these people, other than the fact that Spain is a beautiful country and the Katrina Kaif is really pretty, let's concentrate on the road trip they went for. Let's concentrate on the lives they have for those 7 days, which we will not have for a single time in 4 years in the IT. Right? Which is pretty good. Now, they went on road trip for 7 days and they lived every moment of their life to the fullest. Every day in that trip was like a community for us. And that is the kind of life which you call a large life. They forgot everything which lay behind their work, everything, and then move on. Ladies and gentlemen, try to move on in life. Forget what happened in the past and be positive. These four asked me to come to the table of this contest 2 weeks back. And I signed up for it. I'm like, I'll come for it, and I didn't come up for it. Now why? Because I was scared of the fact that I would get disqualified. Today I can get that fact. Because she don't think folks.
You're an amazing speaker.
But I would have been disqualified. Maybe I would have been disqualified. But perhaps I could have come second, first, or maybe I would just have a good learning experience. I'm regretting. I truly regret not coming for that. Because today I don't have the courage to actually go for a typical speech on the normal stage. Fear. That's a fear comes in. And I know my dad always told me that, son, don't fear the future. For he who fears the future dies 1,000 deaths before his first and only death. Toastmasters and guests, you live life for us. Make it worth it. Every breath you take, every step you take, make it worth the step. Make sure your absence is felt, whether that's your country, your college, your hostel room, anything at all. Make sure you leave a mark wherever you go. I'd like to summarize my speech. I'd like to end my speech using one quote by the very famous Mark Twain. Learn from the past, live in the present, and hope for the future.
Oh, hi. Toastmaster, it was a wonderful speech. You meticulously followed all the objectives. Let me go to each objective specifically. The first objective was to select an appropriate outline. Let me tell you, you had a solid outline. Okay. You used the story message kind of method, like wherein you told a story and then you told what the message, like what you learned from that story. It was pretty cool, and that, you know, it grabbed the attention of all the audience, so that was pretty good. The second thing was your message. The objective was to make your message clear. Your message was pretty clear, and to sum up in a word, your message was, it's your life, make it last. So that was pretty great, and I think that it could have been better if you explained a bit more on what defines a person with a large life and what defines a person with a long life. Like, you could have told what are the qualities of a person who lives a large life. What can we do to achieve that goal? What changes do we have to make to bring the change to bring? What changes do we have to make to be that person? A person who lives a large life. But otherwise, the message was pretty clear and you agree. The third objective was appropriate transitions. You had really great transitions, like you told stories and then you like continuously linked the previous point to the next point. So I like, personally, I didn't feel that I was losing somewhere, like I was losing a point. I felt pretty connected throughout the whole speech. The fourth point was make a pretty good start and ending, which you did pretty great. In your opening, you explained the difference between a large life and a long life. And you told like what a person does when he gets up in the morning. So that was pretty good. And the conclusion. So the second thing I would like to tell you, that at times I felt that you weren't audible. Like, so you were great, but sometimes I felt like sometimes your voice never went a little down. So maybe you can work on that. But the end of your speech, the quote by Mark Twain, it won my heart. It was really wonderful, and overall I would say it was a wonderful season. You taught me, you gave me a different view towards life today. You told me what a large life really means, and thank you for doing that. All the best for all your future speeches and all of this. Thank you.